going to turn out our GMA cover story. Sports superstars Rob Gronkowski and Floyd Mayweather, they've been sued a multi-million-dollar false advertising lawsuit against a popular teeth whitening product that they endorsed. Zareen Shah is in Los Angeles with the details. Good morning, Zareen.
Good morning, George. One company promised their product would brighten your smile, even protect against bacteria and viruses, and that nearly a million people made the big purchase. But a new lawsuit says the teeth whitening products backed by big celebrities are also backed by false advertising.
What do celebrities, professional athletes, and thousands of people just like you have in common?
It's the popular LED teeth whitening kit popping up in your social media feed, endorsed by athletes like Rob Gronkowski and Floyd Mayweather.
The Snow Teeth Whitening System is super easy to use.
But this morning, Snow Teeth Whitening LLC facing a proposed class action lawsuit. New Yorker Burton Claus accusing the company, its founder Gronkowski and Mayweather, of fraudulent, false, and misleading advertising and marketing. Based on what the plaintiff calls false claims that the lights they sell to consumers will dramatically improve the whitening power and antiviral or antiseptic qualities. Legal experts stressing this type of lawsuit can be powerful if it is allowed to proceed as a class action.
A class action lawsuit is essentially a lawsuit where rather than having one plaintiff, one person bringing the lawsuit, there are hundreds, could be thousands of individuals, typically in a class action lawsuit such as this.
The at-home brightening kits retailing for about $200, and Snow touting they've sold nearly 1 million. But the lawsuit, which is seeking class action status, claiming the lights are ineffective for those purposes and are very cheap lights that are similar to models sold online for less than $5. Krause's attorney telling ABC News the defendants are taking advantage of consumers and that in March the defendants began their efforts to profit from the pandemic by falsely suggesting they had a virus-killing option. We are trying to stop them from ripping people off.
They believe what they say. They have credibility. They have trust built up in their name and in their brand. And because of that trust, people go out and spend money with the belief that what that celebrity or endorser said is true.
Now, the company CEO says it's clear this lawsuit is to exploit the celebrities, that the company has less than a 2% return rate, and they still insist their product works. No comment from the celebrity sponsors, though.
Yo, what up, everybody? Good morning. Arie here, and welcome back to another video. So you may or may not know that Snow Teeth Whitening recently got sued in a class action lawsuit, as they just explained, which is pretty crazy. I mean, we just watched this video, and it kind of explained everything and gave us a good summary of what's going on, especially for those of you that may have not heard about this, but I actually went ahead and found the class action lawsuit document. So as you can see, jury trial demanded. So they are going to be going to trial for this. She kind of explained the difference between just like a normal lawsuit and a class action lawsuit. Class action lawsuit apparently means there's multiple people behind it. Could be hundreds, could be thousands, as she said. But I mean, I don't really know. I guess we can just kind of go through this briefly and sort of analyze to see how serious this is. But as they said, and as I've read in other articles that I've been looking up before me in this video, I think they're getting sued for $5 million, which is pretty fucked up. That's a lot of money. I don't think that would be hugely detrimental to them, and I'll explain to you why I think that, but still, you know, I think it's a pretty big deal. You know, I've made a video about lawsuits before, and I'm specifically talking about Fashion Nova. They were recently sued as well, not too recently, it was like 6 months ago. They were sued for some pretty crazy allegations. Apparently they got sued for not giving refunds, which is pretty crazy, but this is a little bit different. So they're getting sued for false advertising. So this article that I found by classaction.org is probably the best article that I've found on this. So let's see. A proposed class action lawsuit alleges teeth whitening products hawked by world champion boxer Floyd Mayweather and former New England Patriots and current Tampa Bay Buccaneers tight end Rob Gronkowski have unjustifiably been sold for far more than they're worth. So this is kind of why it's happening. Some people are saying that this product is not worth what they're charging for it, yet at the same time, people are buying it for that much. And like they said, they have a less than 2% return rate, which means that some people are happy with it. But anyways, according to the 20-page false advertising case, defendants Snow Teeth Whitening LLC Forsold LLC, Mayweather, Gronkowski, and Snow founder Joshua Elizeki have charged consumers nearly $200 for what amount to be ineffective LED-based at-home teeth whitening products that use nothing more than very cheap lights and are no different than similar items sold for much less. So by looking at this, I'm gonna guess that Forsold LLC and these other guys actually have equity in the company. It's just a little fun fact, something interesting to sort of lighten the mood. I mean, I don't know, this is kind of grim stuff to look at. I don't know, it's kind of scary to see these big brands getting sued. But yeah, that's kind of cool that they partnered with influencers and, you know, these big celebrities to grow even more. But anyways, moreover, the defendant's unequivocal claims concerning the product's overall popularity, FDA approval, awards and accolades, and germ-fighting capabilities are equally false, the suit says. The lawsuit alleges the defendants in peddling Snow's accelerating LED mouthpiece, at-home teeth whitening all-in-one kit, original kit, and other wired teeth whitening light devices have engaged in a widespread fraudulent scheme to deceive consumers and demonstrated greed and a complete disregard for human decency by suggesting the products could protect against COVID-19. That's kind of a little far, and I actually didn't see any of those campaigns because I don't really follow Snow Teeth Whitening very closely at all. Even though I have seen interviews of the founder, you know, talking about how he blew up the brand and stuff, because it is very, very impressive stuff from a business standpoint. But you know, when I started looking at it, I guess more from a consumer point of view, maybe I could see where this class action lawsuit kind of makes sense, especially if the product really doesn't work. I've never tried it myself, so I can't really say from experience whether or not it works. But honestly, when I look at this store, I look at their, you know, reviews, I look at their product images, and I look at the traffic that they're continuing to drive to the store, it does make me question whether or not this is another bogus class action lawsuit. I mean, I think when it becomes a class action lawsuit, it kind of becomes less bogus since there are more people backing it. But I'm a little concerned about how easy, I guess, it is to just sue a company over something like this. And it kind of, in my opinion, slightly goes against capitalism and like supply and demand, because maybe they are getting this product for like $5-$10 and selling it for $200, which it is a little messed up. I mean, obviously there's definitely something morally wrong with that in my opinion, but business is business, you know? Our healthcare company is getting sued for charging thousands for medication that cost them, you know, $10, $50 to make. I don't know. So that's sort of where I have an issue with this. But suggesting that a product like this could protect against COVID-19, come on, you're obviously gonna get in trouble for that. That's obviously not gonna be true. I don't think that's true. That sounds like a far reach. So they said, while defendants unequivocally claim that their teeth whitening light delivers amazing results, independent lab testing proves that, in fact, their light does nothing to enhance their product's purported ability to whiten teeth, the lawsuit filed in New York's Eastern District Court claims. So apparently they've done some independent lab testing that proves that this product really doesn't do anything. I mean, that's kind of vague. It doesn't really say exactly what they tested or what they actually proved. I mean, I think maybe they're still talking about this COVID thing, which is obviously not gonna work in my opinion. So we'll see. Lawsuit claims Snow teeth whitening products are ineffective. The lawsuit chides the defendants for claiming that Snow's teeth whitening serum is proprietary when in truth, there's nothing proprietary about it, given it's simply a mix of two types of peroxide, hydrogen, and carbamide. Further, the complaint condemns the defendants for absurdly claiming that Snow products cause no teeth sensitivity despite selling an add-on made specifically for sensitive teeth called the desensitizing gum to reduce sensitivity that may result from using the teeth whitening lights. As far as how fast Snow teeth whitening lights supposedly work, the lawsuit, citing independent lab testing, says the defendant's claims that users will see results within 3 days are false. So, I mean, like I said, they continue to reference this independent lab testing, which sounds really credible and legit, I guess, but I've yet to see any proof of that. So, like, you could say really anything. I mean, obviously, that's a bold claim saying that you'll see results within 3 days, but I could see something like this. You know, within 3 days, your teeth getting whiter. And I mean, that's what their company is about. I mean, I don't think their company is about having like the most healthy teeth ever. I think it's literally just about whitening teeth. I mean, it's literally in their name. And I'm just trying to play devil's advocate here. Honestly, I'm on no one's side. I do like supporting businesses. Obviously, I love entrepreneurship, but I'm also a consumer and I'm a man of the people. So I don't fully agree with these business practices, but I'm still slightly concerned over this lawsuit. So let's see what this says here. In October 2019 on trysnow.com, defendants defendants claim that the all-in-one kit has a patent-pending LED mouthpiece that accelerates the teeth whitening process. However, independent laboratory testing performed on the defendants' teeth whitening products reveals that defendants' LED mouthpiece produced no material added benefit in terms of speed or effectiveness of whitening when compared with using Snow's whitening serum alone. Put differently, independent lab testing revealed that defendants are lying to consumers by suggesting that their expensive light will accelerate whitening results when in fact it does no such thing. The case goes on to say Eli Zitke, which is the founder, I don't know how to say that last name, lied to the viewing public when he appeared on the Home Shopping Network in November 2019 and claiming the Snow Serum contained a photocatalyst, an ingredient that accelerates teeth whitening when exposed to light by breaking down peroxide faster. This claim is also false, the lawsuit says. Given the stated ingredients for the Snow Teeth Whitening Serum sold on HSN do not include any photocatalyst. So he said it includes photocatalyst, but it doesn't. So that is a red flag for sure. According to the suit, the defendants have not spent nearly as much time or money, 3 years and over $2.3 million in research and development, on the Snow Teeth Whitening products as they claim. Further, no clinical trials exist to back up the defendant's statements, and Snow's founder, Eli Zitke, doesn't even use the product himself, the case alleges. Eli Zitke falsely claims that his white teeth are the result of using defendant's products, but he has veneers, a fact he hides from consumers. Holy shit, this is getting deep, like holy fuck. They are like coming at this man's life. This is not cool, man, wow. But yeah, 3 years and $2.3 million in research and development, that sounds a little bit sus. I'm kind of suspicious of those numbers as well. $2.3 million in research and development with no clinical trials, that doesn't really make much sense to me. And honestly, this is a really good learning lesson for anybody starting a business in like the healthcare sector. Like, oh man, you're gonna be dealing with a lot of issues like this. But it is surprising that they've done no clinical trials while claiming that they've spent so much on research and development. And I guess that is kind of bogus to say that your teeth got whiter with your product if you have veneers. That's not really fair. I mean, veneers are literally like fake teeth. So let's see, red light, blue light. The lawsuit relays that Snow Teeth whitening products have also been peddled to consumers alongside questionable suggestions that different colored LED lights can aid in fighting germs. Per the complaint, one of the defendant's advertisements falsely suggests that a blue LED light and hydrogen peroxide will protect Snow users from germ and bacteria, while another ad referencing quarantine suggests that a red LED light option will prevent infection. There are no studies, however, that suggest an overpriced blue or red light materially improves the antiseptic qualities of hydrogen peroxide, the suit says, adding that the defendant's ads and public statements certainly do not cite to any. So they're making claims that they haven't really researched, they're just kind of masters of marketing. Further, the defendants have also fraudulently claimed that their wired teeth whitening light, the kind seen in promotional ads featuring Gronkowski and Mayweather, is patented or patent pending and approved by the FDA, the suit asserts. The FDA, however, has never approved any of the defendant's products, the lawsuit says. At any rate, cosmetic products such as those that whiten teeth are not even subject to FDA approval, according to the case. What? I would have totally expected this to be FDA approved. That's actually really concerning. Like, bro, I'm not gonna be putting any teeth whitening stuff in my mouth. Not that the FDA is necessarily like the biggest source of, you know, of health or anything, but I mean, putting this like ultraviolet looking light in my mouth to whiten my teeth definitely seems like it could cause issues, and I would have for sure expected this to be FDA approved, especially if they've said that their patent is FDA approved. After ad industry watchdog truthinadvertising.org published an article in June 2019 criticizing Snow for using the FDA logo, the company allegedly began to conceal the icon in its advertisements and social media posts. In addition to making false statements regarding FDA approval, the defendants are also accused of having fabricated awards and accolades from well-known publications. As the lawsuit tells it, the falsehood spread by the defendants could benefit from more than a little fact-checking. Their lies are so brazen, they falsely claim to have customers in over 200 countries around the world, yet there are not even 200 countries in the world. Oh man, this is kind of funny. With regards to the apparent popularity of Snow Teeth whitening products, the lawsuit says that while the defendants claim to have 500,000 happy customers and 16,000 five-star reviews, Their rating on the Home Shopping Network is only 2.7 out of 5. In general, the defendants have chosen to downplay the fact that their teeth whitening products have performed poorly in the court of public opinion, the complaint alleges. Wow, that was actually a really good way to put that. This product has performed really poorly in the court of public opinion, so they went on the Home Shopping Network and their score of 2.7 out of 5, that's a little bit over half. That's pretty bad, obviously, which really says a lot about the product. And that's the one thing I will say, that you never really know exactly if reviews are legit. I mean, especially with all these marketing tactics that this company is using, now I'm actually starting to get a little bit suspicious. Like, this is a little bit crazy. And just because a lot of people have bought it doesn't really mean to me anymore that the product is good, because they do say a lot of different things. They have a lot of marketing tactics that, as this article states, have proven to be false, and they've said things in their advertising that are proven to be exaggerations or misleading advertising. I mean, look, I'm not a lawyer here. Law is cool, but I'm not a lawyer. So honestly, I don't really know exactly how illegal all these things are. I mean, clearly they're a big deal if they're getting a class action suit against them. But I'm curious to know where you draw the line, because I know that there's so many e-commerce companies out there that say these really wild statements like best cookies in the world or something. And you know, are they gonna get sued if they're not like scientifically proven to be the best cookies in the world? This is of course a very diluted version of this class action lawsuit, the example that I just gave out, but it's certainly something to think about. We're almost done with this article, but defendants have not disclosed the number of unhappy customers, such as the plaintiff, the suit reads, contending that similar products offered by competitors, which tend to retail for less than $50 per kit, are far more popular. Consumers could purchase whitening strips or whitening pens from numerous competitors for under $50, or even $40 or $30, the suit says. Thus, defendants are charging consumers $100 more than arguably compared products for a light that does nothing with respect to teeth whitening. Who's covered by the lawsuit? The lawsuit, which alleges violations of New York's general business law, looks to represent New York residents who bought the defendant's accelerating LED mouthpiece, original at-home teeth whitening all-in-one kit, or wired teeth whitening light device during the applicable statute of limitations period. So this article is basically actually kind of finding people to represent this lawsuit, or to sign up for this lawsuit. So they're getting an army of people to storm against Snow Whitening Kit. And I mean, this was in December 15th, so it was like almost exactly a month ago. And yeah, I just kind of remembered about this, and I figured, you know what, I actually didn't talk about this on my channel yet at all, and I haven't even done much research on it myself. So this was a good opportunity for me to do some research and make a video for y'all. So hopefully you enjoyed this. I mean, my overall thoughts on this are, I do see why they got sued. You know, these are very controversial things to have said, and I've always been slightly wary of their products. And I guess, you know, maybe we're not giving them enough credit. Maybe they do a lot of research and development, but the fact that they've never ran clinical trials yet claim all these clinical things is slightly concerning for sure. But at the same time, I also feel like consumers should be educated enough to make their own buying decisions without having to be, you know, handheld through the whole process. Like, if you see something like this and you're wary, there are other competitors out there that people could shop from. So, you know, even though they do a lot of, like, you know, over 500,000 sold, and they do a lot of this like really big marketing, I think that's kind of their main forte, is marketing as opposed to necessarily product development. But there are many, many companies out there like that. So I don't know. I just don't know where you draw the line. That's basically my main concern here. But let me know what you guys think. I'm really curious for your opinion, of course. Let me know in the comments if you knew about this or whatever you think about this. And with that said, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have an amazing rest of your day. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.